All of you, welcome to the online classes of TMPS. Welcome back. We'll be discussing about the chapter number 1, Indus Valley Civilization, which we have studied earlier also. Now today we'll be finishing this chapter and then we'll be moving towards the question answers of this chapter. I hope you remember that Indus Valley Civilization was basically a civilization that was flourishing around 5000 years ago. It is considered to be the oldest civilization of the earth, because here we came to know about the different aspects. I have told you there were two main great sites, Harappan civilization and the Mohenjo-daro civilization, which constituted Indus Valley civilization. These are the river valley civilizations which were flourished near a river. Now we will be basically talking about the things which were left in the previous chapter. We have discussed about the town planning, how they were doing the town planning. They were exquisite in their town planning. They were very good in the proper planning, development and implementing their skills. Now we will be discussing the things which are left. Now you can refer to the previous video also, and then you can go through the whole chapter and we'll be doing the question answer. Next is amusements. What do you understand by the term amusements? Amusements basically means things which were they doing for the entertainment. You know, there were no televisions, no internet at that moment. Electricity was also not there. So what they were doing for the entertainment. So the basic thing they were doing were, they were having the form of dancing, they were celebrating, where there were musics were there, they used to have paintings, art, sculpture. So for the amusements, they were having different dice games, their different clay toys were there for the small children. It was being found that the small clay toys were also there for the children. There was storytelling, folk tales which were there for the amusement of the Indus Valley people. Now we'll be going to the next topic, that what was the painting, art and sculpture. Painting, art and sculpture at that moment was at its great height. They also knew the use of metallurgy. They also knew the art of sculpture. Short-legged yogi is also a perfect example for that. A short-legged yogi statue is being found, which is a perfect example of sculpture. A Nataraj position idol was also found. A position of dancing, bronze statue of a dancing girl is found for a sculpture. In painting, we have found that there were different, you have studied about a crow and a fox story. That story is basically implemented from there. There is a picture of a fox sitting down and a crow is on the tree. So there were very beautiful stories, and they were masters of their painting. They used to make the painting colors with the leaves and the flowers which were found at that time. They were exquisite in their work, and they were doing their work at the remarkable rate and pace. Next, we will be talking about, they were very good at the pottery also. You know that what is pottery? They used to have pots. They used to have clay utensils which were also there. But they were having glazed toys. They were having glazed paintings. You know about the China clay. They had paintings over their clay pots. They had a China clay, China dish is also being found. So it is being found that they had a trade relationship with the Western Asian countries, and they had a good relationship with the other civilizations that must have flourished around that period. Next, we'll be talking about, what were seals? Seals are a very important thing which tell us many things about the Indus Valley people. We found various clay-like tablets. They are circular in shape. They are clay-like tablets which are known as seals. These seals are considered to be used for the trade purpose from one place to another, because many seals have been found in other civilizations such as Mesopotamian civilization, Chinese civilization, which were found in the Indus Valley people and Indus Valley time. So what happened that the seals were basically are used for the trade purpose. There were various seals which were being used, such as a bison seal. The most prominent seal was the Pashupati seal. You know, Lord Shiva is known as Pashupati because of his lord of all the wild animals. That is why the Pashupati seal is the most important seal. And this seal was used for the trade purpose. Indians had a, Indus Valley civilization basically had a good trade relationship with the Western Asian countries. We had a good civilization trade with these Western Asian countries. Now we'll be talking about the religion. Religion of the Indus Valley people, they were considered to be early Hindus. What they were considered to be? They were considered to be early Hindus. Why they were considered to be early Hindus? Because we have found that they were the idols of deities. Deities basically are the gods. You know who are deities? Deities are the gods. So we have a statue of idol and deities. There was a Shakti. Daughter Shakti was considered to be the chief god, and their nature gods were being prayed. They prayed sun, they prayed fire, they prayed water, and different animals such as the bison, crocodile, snake. These were also considered to be the persons from which they should be afraid and they should basically pray for them. So they were also found embedded in the seals. Many times the seals were also there. They used to burn earthen lamps. You know that lamps are there, earthen lamps, clay pot lamps were there basically, which were being burned in front of the deities, because a smoke like things have been accumulated on the idols of the deities, which can only be there due to the firing of that earthen lamp, the lightning of the earthen lamp. So they used to follow the early Hindu civilization. They are considered to be the early Hindus, but they do not used to burn their individuals. They used to bury them. It is being found that they had used to bury their people which they died. They did not used to basically burn them as we are doing at this moment. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Now we'll be coming to the last topic of this chapter, that is basically what are the causes for the decline of the Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley civilization was considered to be a prominent civilization at that moment, which was having lots of good things. The people were having development, they had growth. So what was the reason for the decline of the Indus Valley civilization? There are various reasons. So first reason we can consider is that attack of Aryans. You know that Aryans were the people which were basically succeeding the Indus Valley people. After Indus Valley people, Indus Valley civilization, we study about the Aryans. So it was considered that Aryans who migrated from the Western Asia, they must have attacked the Indus Valley people and killed them. Second point, it was considered there must have been some natural disaster such as earthquake, floods, volcano eruption, that must have led to the decline of the Indus Valley civilization. Third, it was considered that they used to have burnt bricks. I have told you that they used to have burnt bricks for making their houses. So they must have cut down the trees in an indiscriminate manner. They must have cut down the trees on a large scale, which had led to the decline of the Indus Valley people, as it must have changed the ecological balance and the water would have been basically dried up. It is also considered to be a reason. Then it is another reason also considered that Indus Valley people must have died due to an epidemic. There must have been an epidemic that has been caused, due to which the people have died. So I hope this chapter is clear to you, Indus Valley civilization. This is the first chapter of your ninth, and I hope that these things are clear to you. Please go through the video once again. I have told you there are various important things, there were various sites, their town planning, and this is a very important portion that you should